Tonight I wanna get high. It's the end. Hey y'all, I missed you guys so much, like so much. I like tried to come up with a whole YouTube schedule. It is just not working out. I just post when I have content, and when I feel it's not even about having content. I have plenty of content. It's the editing for me. Why didn't somebody tell me editing was gonna be that hard and that long? Like, no one told me, but I gotta get this information out to you guys because you guys are my girls. And I have a new look that I have tried, and I just want to share it with you guys. Before I like created the first Kennedy, the first time I created Sasha, I literally just did it very spontaneously. I had a ready to ship wig, and I know these girls out here don't want no boring black wig anymore. It's 2022. They want their wigs spiced up, but not too spicy, not too spicy. So I was like, let me think of something I can do. And like, honestly, with hair, just from watching people for a while, you just kind of like learn certain things. And I just feel like in my head, I already envisioned on how to do this wig, and I just did it. So just follow my steps and I will help you guys out. So yeah. All right, let's get into it. So I like making things very simple in my tutorials. If you were too distracted by me talking a lot, just go back. Because what I did first was place my wig on the mannequin the correct way. It seems so stupid, but it's the most important and crucial thing you have ever done in your whole entire life. Okay. And then I think in my head, Where are the spots that I want to have like pick-a-boo bright red from? Where do I want to have it? So I wanted to hide it a little bit. So I picked the two spots like close to the ear section. I picked like maybe two spots in the back where I wanted like a little pick-a-boo. And I also put like two strips in the front. And I braided all that up, braided it all up. And almost every single piece. Y'all see that piece right there? Yeah, no. All right, but almost every piece, you want to gather it all up and then pin it up out the way. You don't need that. You ain't doing nothing with it. Leave it out the way. Those are my braids. I did it under close to the ear. You already know. So that's the bleach I use. That's the developer I use. You can get this at Sally's, Amazon, all of that. So I mix it together. And remember, y'all, we are not bleaching knots. We are dyeing hair. So it's not going to be as thick of a consistency as you would think. The mixture of the bleach is like kind of runny, but not, you know, not extra runny, but it's kind of runny. But yeah. All right, now, so don't judge me, judge Mammy. So I did not have gloves right now while I'm doing this bleach stuff. When I do the other part, I did have gloves, but I did not have gloves. Okay, I was using bleach I had already had on hand, blah blah blah. I was not going to Sally's. I was not. I'm sorry. So I used a piece of like wax paper just to like stop the bleach from reaching to my hands. I just kept using it because I knew I only needed to bleach those, you know, I think it's 5 spots. So yeah, I also didn't record me combing through it afterwards. I combed through each part after I bleached it, just so I can make sure it's getting, you know, bleached to the best capability. So yeah, I put the bleach all over every single braiding part. Obviously, I take out the braid and start doing that. I believe I left it on for at least an additional 20-25 minutes after I applied the bleach on all parts. So yeah, watch me while I'll do that. Smoking ride and pull up on me. Don't play with me. He gonna make time for a bitch like me. Real P-I-M-P. Been out all day, come stay with me. Stay on with me. Put so wet all on the sheets.
Tonight I sleep with nothing on. In a bed with nothing on. Tonight I sleep, sleep. In a bed with nothing on. Tonight I sleep, sleep. In a bed with nothing on. Tonight I sleep, sleep. In a bed with nothing on.
In my feels, in all kind of ways. I be trying to wait, but lately I just wanna keep it real, real. No more playing safe, let's take it all the way. I'm just saying, I just wanna make time for you. Swear it's just right for you, like this pussy designed for you. 10 out of 5 on you, know I was lying on a line for you. Bet I look nice on you, open my mind for you. Don't wanna wait on it tonight, I wanna get nasty.
Okay, so right after you're done with that, you want to go ahead and protect that lace. Well, obviously rinse that out, but protect that lace. I use some free spray, and I literally hit the front of the wig, the back of the wig twice, blow dried it in between, and then I also went back over it with some black bottle got to be glue gel, and I smeared that all across that area, as you can see, sorry. And then I blow dried it. Okay, and then this is the red I used for that wig that you've seen. But normally I use the red one. It was just the place I went to was sold out. I put it in like a little bottle like that because it just makes my life easier. Like, I did multiple Sasha units, so I was trying to do the quickest method ever, okay? But still get the job done. So I also still have some leftover like conditioner in the wig, so mind your business, but I wanted to keep the wig in the best condition possible, so I just kept a little bit in there because I'm bleaching a lot. I'm doing a lot to the wig, you know. All right, so I just obviously I'm just smearing it around, blending it all together. You know, make sure you hit every single spot, don't miss no spots, smear it all together. Like, this is pretty, you know, you see, you do. So just keep watching me. Obviously, I'm just keep going over the same spots, making sure I hit every single piece. Yeah, after I get done coloring you guys, I even go back and like literally scatter through the whole entire wig, making sure I hit every single spot. Cause you have to, like, that girl paid for it. She want her wig red, not have spots, okay? So yeah. And I wanted to give you guys a little bonus too. I also went over on how I do baby hair in this video. And I put it all the way at the end for my real homies to see this. Because if you made it this far, you deserve a little extra. So here's a little tip from Chris. So obviously I separate my baby hair a very thin layer. I take my time. And each piece that is not supposed to be the baby hair, I push back, comb it back, make sure it is out the way, okay? Because that just, it stresses me out. So then I go with the black got to be glue gel, or I use Eco, it just depends on what I have. Then I use my Nairobi right on top of that. And this literally sets your baby hairs up for, like, freaking success. Like, there's no way you can mess up baby hair if you do that method. Because the gel keeps it down, the mousse helps it move and swoop. So yeah, that's how I did the baby hair. Afterwards, I blow dry it so it can stay in place. And that's basically it, y'all. I know this tutorial was like literally all over the place and a little ghetto, a little bit unprofessional. But we got through this. And thank you so much for watching through the whole entire thing. And make sure y'all watch my other videos too. And I miss you guys. I'm going to try to post at least like once a month. Is that cool? Because y'all girls be wanting videos all the time. But I really hope you guys enjoyed this. I love this freaking wig. Pre-orders are back open on Monday. And I'm just so excited. I hope you guys are excited because I am. And make sure y'all look at the other YouTube videos I have, okay? Make sure you comment, like, and subscribe, girls. Subscribe.